Yo, what's up with my YouTube family? How y'all doing today, man? Cowboy coming at you. I'm outside, man. It's pretty nice out this evening, so I figured I'd come on outside and share a little something with y'all. Do a little something I ain't done in a while. So what we doing today, cowboy? Well, cowboy, would like to welcome you to another episode of Cigar and Whiskey Balling on a Budget. Let's have one with the Whiskey Squad today. So we ain't gonna mess around with this thing, man. Cowboy gonna go ahead and get into it and let y'all know what we doing, man. This is for my budget-friendly folk. I know y'all ain't seen me in a while. Probably wondering when Cowboy coming back with another one of them Cigar and Whiskey Balling on a Budget. Well, we getting ready to do it tonight. So, what I present to you guys for the cigar is, this is the Casablanca Nicaragua. Now, this is a JR cigar. Casablanca has been around for quite some time. They had a totally different line by JR Cigars. If you guys go to jrcigar.com, you'll be able to find that. This particular Casablanca here was done by AJ Fernandez. That's why it's called the Casablanca Nicaragua. Revamped at AJ Fernandez's factory for JR Cigars. So it's a good looking cigar, man, as you can see. Got quite a bit of band on there. It says Casablanca Nicaragua on it. Got the black foot band there. What I do enjoy about these foot bands is the fact that they do help to protect the cigar, man, in case you were to drop it or to crack it or anything. So I don't have any issues with the foot bands on these cigars. Helps to protect that foot. But this is a good chocolate looking beauty, man. I mean, look at that thing. Nice and chocolatey. Got some toothiness to it. Just a nice dark brown wrapper. This thing is dressed in the Connecticut broadleaf wrapper, Mexican San Andreas binder, and Dominican fillers. And I want to say some time ago, I thought that this cigar had something else other than Dominican filler in it. Maybe I'm wrong, I'm not sure. Looks to have a double cap on it. Great smell to it. Nice dark coffee note, chocolate, barnyard, deep cedar, and funk. Nice smell to the cigar, but good looking cigar so far. So we're gonna go ahead and cut this thing, man. Then I'm gonna get into the drink that I'm gonna have with you guys tonight. Cowboy's gonna do a V-cut on this thing real quick. Let's see what kind of draw we got. A little bit of pepper right there on the cold draw. Nice chocolate note. Earthy. Chocolate with a little bit of pepper. 6x50 Toro, that's the size on this thing if I fail to mention that. But good looking stick, man. So this stick goes for about $5.50 around here in my area. I think you can go on jrcigars.com and get them for about the same price, $5.56 a stick. I think you can get the 5-pack for under $30. So that's less than $6 for the cigar. Nice cold draw. Just straight coffee and tobacco there on the foot. So, for the drink, what we having tonight, cowboy? We gonna go Irish tonight. Cigar and Whiskey Balling on the Budget with Cowboy, baby. We gonna drink some Jameson. The Triple Distill, Trice as Smooth. Jameson Irish Whiskey. Now, this is probably not new to a lot of you guys. I don't know how many of you guys are into your Irish whiskeys, but the Jameson is one that I do drink quite a bit of when I go to an Irish whiskey. I seem to drink a lot more Jameson in the summertime for some reason, and I'll let you guys know why a little later. But Jameson is probably, well, I know Jameson for a fact is the most sold Irish whiskey globally. And I think for American whiskey, it's Jack Daniel's, but they're right up there, one and two. with the most sales for whiskey globally. Jameson, this one goes 40% alcohol by volume, so that's 80 proof. Very nice blend. This is a whiskey that a lot of people like to take shots of when they're at the bar and they let's do a shot of Jameson. So we're going to pull this Jameson up and we're going to fire this cigar up and we're going to see what the pairing is. I hope everybody's having a good day, man. Cowboy couldn't wait any longer to come back for my budget-friendly folk. Give y'all a little something I haven't given you all in a while. And I think maybe I'm telling you about a whiskey that maybe you guys already know quite a bit about, or maybe you haven't tried it. But this cigar, I'm not sure how many of you guys have even knew that there was a Casablanca Nicaraguan cigar out at JRCigars.com, made by AJ Fernandez. So let's get this thing lit, see where we at. It's a beautiful night out tonight, folks. I know it's been a while since Cowboy's been on. You know, we kind of taking a step back a little bit, man, and not trying to do too much. It's a little crazy out here on the scene with the cigar reviews. And I have to be careful when I use that word reviewer. I really am just an opinionist. Cigar opinionist at work, baby. Giving y'all my opinion on that cigar on that particular day. And a little bit of whiskey here and there. Right, here we go. On first light, coming off of that retro, get a nice blast of that's a black and white pepper mix there for me. Got some creaminess going on there already off the cigar. Nice woodiness. Nice creaminess, a little bit of coffee there, and definitely a black and white pepper there on the retro. Cigar's got a pretty nice aroma to it, really nice feel in the hand to the cigar. The Casablanca Nicaragua. So, we're gonna continue to smoke it down and see what else it gives us. It's got a nice creaminess there to it already, so let's see where that goes. Yeah. For the Jameson, Irish whiskey. Very nice and smooth whiskey. Look at that nice color on that whiskey, man. Pot still whiskey. Been around for a very, very long time. I failed to mention that the whiskey around here in my parts, I get this for about $19.99, so say $20. $20 for the fifth of whiskey, $6 for the cigar. Cigar and whiskey balling for under $30. I think y'all can handle that. Let's get a smell. Very light, honey is probably the only sweetness that I'm getting right there on the smell so far. Still got that pepper in my nose from the cigar, but very nice and smooth smell to that. Let's give it a taste. Salute. Very smooth whiskey, man. Great summertime whiskey, in my opinion. Easy drinker. Doesn't burn. Goes down smooth. Great choice. So, Cowboy's gonna continue to drink, smoke this thing down, man. We'll come back and let you guys know where we at. Y'all relax. Look at that cigar, folks. Performing well so far. Cigar smoking good. Got nice billowing smoke to it. Good looking grayish white ash there. I mean, nice looking ash. Nice looking burn, nice looking burn line. Nice slick looking wrapper there as well. It's rustic and slick all at the same time. But not smoking bad. For a $5.50 cigar, the Casablanca Nicaragua, made for JR Cigars by AJ Fernandez, not smoking bad. Jameson whiskey is going down too smooth. Folks, you got to be careful with the Jameson. It's so smooth if you're not careful. You drink too much of it. But I am enjoying it. One of the finest whiskeys on the planet. Nice Irish whiskey. But so far on the cigar, just a really smooth smoking cigar. I can already tell that this cigar is not going to be overly complex. Just a good straight down the middle cigar with a few flavors. I got that dry Dominican earth going on with the cigar. Got a slight creaminess going on there. That retro for me. I'm going to say that retro now. Tad bit of Florida, just a tad bit. And I'm going to say it's white pepper. The black pepper that I'm getting is more of a black pepper spice that's kind of like on the back of the throat. It's woody. Got a nice woodiness there to it. Good cedar wood. Maybe a tad bit of oak there as well, but definitely woody. I'm picking up a bready cracker note to go along with that little bit of dry earthiness. And I'm going to say that right now this cigar is smoking medium in strength, on the low side of medium on the body, low side of medium on the flavors. Not a bad smoking cigar, but not a complex cigar right now at all. Hoping that the flavors are going to pick up on a little bit more, because that dark wrapper just seems as though it's going to give me a little bit more flavor than what I'm getting right now. But I tell you what, for the price, I wouldn't have a problem smoking this cigar again. Salute. So we'll keep smoking. Cowboy's gonna come back and show you all a nice little summer cocktail that I make myself. You guys have heard me say before, very seldom are you gonna ever see me mix my whiskeys with anything. But in the summertime, I do come up with a nice cocktail that I normally make with this Jameson on a hot summer day. I have one when you guys get back. As you guys can see, the Casablanca, Nicaragua, for JR Cigars by AJ Fernandez. It's got a nice white, thick smoke to it. That band's gonna have to come off of there real soon. I hate that. I'm really digging that band for some reason on that dark wrapper. That is a really good looking band. It's simple, but it's nice. As you can see, the cigar's starting to get just a tad bit wavy there on me, on the burn. I have not had to touch it up just yet, but we're gonna see what happens with that. I'm getting a little bit of nice dry chocolate on the cigar. The cigar still got a nice dry earthiness to it. If you guys like a nice dry earthiness to a cigar that's not overpowering, this is a great cigar for you. Got a nice cedar wood profile to it. With maybe even a little bit of oak there. Still got that white pepper with a tad bit of Florida on the retro. Good construction to the cigar. I'm not having any problems with the construction on the cigar. Let's go ahead and take that band off right now as we get down to the second portion of this. Like I said, the cigar is smoking well. This will be a great everyday cigar for someone. A good yard gar, as they call it. It'd be great for the golf course. Really decent cigar. Not bad. For the price, I mean, you can't beat it. $5.50. Can't beat that stick. Great smoke. Got a nice mild aroma to it as well. So I'm enjoying the cigar. I mean, like I said, it's not overly complex at all. I'm gonna say that right now the cigar is still smoking medium in strength. And I'm gonna say still low to medium on the body. And it's getting up there to medium on the flavors. There are more flavors that are trying to come out of the cigar, but they aren't really hitting me the way that I want them to, quick enough, but not bad. There's a little bit of cinnamon there on the cigar as well. I was really waiting for that cinnamon to come on out and grab me. But the cinnamon is there. Before I got down to the second portion of the cigar was really holding a nice ash. It held just over a 1-inch ash before it broke off. That cinnamon, there that cinnamon is. I'm getting that cinnamon now. Still got a tad bit of black pepper on the back of the throat. Not a bad smoking cigar. So as I said, we cigar and whiskey balling on the budget. So let Cowboy show you all what my summertime cocktail is. On a nice cool day, what I do, went in and got a big cube. So we drop the big cube in. We take some Jameson. And I go mainly 2 parts Jameson. And then I mix that with some ginger ale. Very refreshing. What I don't have with me that I would normally put in this cocktail is a lime. So that's the Jameson and ginger ale. Normally I have a twist of lime with it. Very refreshing. Let's see what we got. Salute. Very nice. You guys got to try this if you haven't before. Like I said, you're not going to see me mix my whiskeys often, but this is definitely a great summer cocktail for me. Very, very tasty, folks. You guys try that and let Cowboy know what you think about it. So, we're going to go ahead and continue to smoke this Casablanca down. We get down to the last portion of it. Cowboy, come back and give you my final thoughts on it and my final score. Well. Here we are, down to the last bit of it. The 6x50 Toro, $5.50 stick. The Casablanca Nicaragua Deluxe Maduro from JR Cigars by AJ Fernandez. Now, I'm not exactly sure what AJ did to this cigar when they gave him the blend, what he did different, but I'm not disappointed with the cigar at all. For the price, this cigar gave me exactly what I expected to get from it. Like I say, this is a good everyday cigar. I think this cigar would really, really pair well with a dark coffee. This is not a bad smoking cigar. As we get down to the last portion of the cigar began to amp up. The flavors begin to pick up a little bit. Now, most of us that are cigar smokers, you guys excuse the noise in the background, I am outside. Sirens around here, you hear those a lot. But the cigar's not bad. I begin to pick up a slight bit of leather there as I get down to the last portion of it. Still white pepper on the retro with a tad bit of floral. The black pepper that I was getting on the back of the throat is not there anymore. Got a nice coffee creaminess to the cigar as well. Still got that dry earthiness. Got a nice dry chocolate note to the cigar as well. Not a whole lot of transitions in the cigar. Like I say, as we get down to the last portion of the cigar, begin to amp up a little bit. But the cigar is really, it's just smoking straight down the middle. Like I said, not overly complex. Good golf course cigar. A good cigar to just to be working out in the yard with. I'm not disappointed with the cigar at all. I will definitely smoke it again. It's definitely five-pack worthy for you guys for the price. I say go to JRCigar.com. Pick up a five-pack. Tell me what you guys think about it. Now, I've been smoking Casablanca cigars for as long as I can remember. I've been smoking cigars now for about 28 years, and I've been smoking the Casablanca for at least as long. The original Casablanca that I smoked was a 6x60, the first big ring cigar that I smoked. This Casablanca came in a 7x70. I don't like cigars that size, but I did smoke that 7x70, different wrapper than this one. I can't remember what that wrapper was, but it wasn't a disappointing cigar because I bought a lot of those cigars. This is definitely a good buddy jar cigar. If you gave this to one of your friends that came over and you passed them out to a few of your buddies, they wouldn't be disappointed in this cigar at all. I begin to also pick up a little bit of a slight mineral note on the cigar. Definitely earthy, mineral. The cinnamon is there. The sweetness on the cigar is there, but it's kind of muted. But not bad. I'm going to say that the cigar is going to finish medium in strength. Low to medium on the body, and somewhere between low to almost medium on the flavors. But as you can see, I'm smoking this thing right on down. The burn as we got through it hasn't been perfect, but it hasn't been bad. And I will tell you what, the Jameson cocktail that Cowboy made up with the Jameson and the ginger ale is magnificent. I'm truly, truly enjoying this drink. So we cigar and whiskey balling on a budget, baby. Like I said, the cigar, $5.50 for the stick, $20 for a fifth of Jameson. I got you under $30. I think you guys can handle that. Not bad for me. I enjoy it. So, Cowboy's going to go ahead and score this thing on my scale of 1 to 10. We are going to give the construction a 10. I give the burn a 9. I give the flavors a 7. The body, I give it a 6. And for complexity and transition, I give it a 6 as well. So that gives the Casablanca Nicaraguan Deluxe Maduro an overall score of a 7.6 on my scale of 1 to 10 for the night. And on my scale of 1 to 10, that makes this an above average cigar. Definitely one to try. You guys go out and get it. If you haven't tried Jameson, if you're not into the Irish whiskey, I challenge you guys to go out and start with this one. There are a few more that I can introduce you guys to, and I'll do that to you guys later. But not bad for Cowboy tonight, honestly. Above average cigar. Like I said, I'll definitely smoke it again. So, Cowboy's going to get out of here and enjoy the rest of my evening. I'm going to continue to watch a little bit of NBA. I expect you guys to enjoy your evening also. This is Cowboy. Hope you guys enjoyed the review. That's my take on it. Cigar and whiskey balling on the budget, baby. Peace. Whiskey Squad.